नमस्कार। भारतीय फिल्म और टेलीविजन संस्थान के स्टाफ, स्टूडेंट्स और फैकल्टी की तरफ से आप सभी का बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ स्वर्णांजलि के ये एक और बहुत ही बेहतरीन कार्यक्रम में। एक उपक्रम जो हमने शुरू किया है टू पे ट्रिब्यूट टू अवर ओन पीपल ऑफ आर इंडस्ट्री। तो आज का ये जो भाग है, ये जो फूल है, वो समर्पित है स्वर्गीय श्री राज खोसला जी के नाम। गूगल मीट के माध्यम से और फेसबुक लाइव के माध्यम से हमसे जुड़ने वाले सभी का मैं बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ। राज खोसला साहब, जिन्होंने 1954 में अपनी पहली फिल्म बनाई जिसका नाम था मिलाप, और 1989 में अपनी आखिरी फिल्म बनाई जिसका नाम था नकाब, मगर इन दोनों के बीच में उन्होंने बहुत बड़ा काम किया। वैसे देखा जाए तो ये है सिर्फ 35 साल का एक समय, मगर उसमें उन्होंने 28 फिल्में बनाई। उस 28 फिल्मों में 26 फिल्म का निर्देशन उन्होंने किया, एक फिल्म प्रोड्यूस की। वो प्रोड्यूस की उसमें उसके पीछे भी एक बहुत अच्छी चीज है, उनके जो गुरु थे गुरुदत्त साहब, उन्होंने राज खोसला साहब के लिए एक फिल्म प्रोड्यूस की थी, क्योंकि राज खोसला साहब गुरुदत्त साहब के असिस्टेंट थे। तो अपने असिस्टेंट के लिए खोसला साहब ने भी एक फिल्म प्रोड्यूस की जिसके डायरेक्टर थे पद्मनाभ जी। उस फिल्म का नाम था दो चोर। तो उन्होंने ये चीज आगे कायम रखी अपने गुरु से जो सीख उन्होंने ली थी। और एक फिल्म जो ऐसी थी जिसके लिए उन्होंने सुनील दत्त साहब की मदद करी थी। तो ऐसी कुल मिला के 28 फिल्में उन्होंने सिर्फ 35 साल में बनाई, जो कि एक अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़ा काम है। और खोसला साहब को हम में से गए हुए इस जून के महीने में 30 साल हो रहे हैं। तो इसी वजह से हमने सोचा कि खोसला साहब को एक श्रद्धांजलि अर्पित करनी चाहिए। तो उसी की वजह से आज का ये स्मरणांजलि कार्यक्रम है। खोसला साहब ने एन दत्ता जी के साथ अपने करियर की शुरुआत की। म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर पहला काम जो उनका था वो एन दत्ता साहब का था, मगर उसके बाद कई अलग अलग म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर के साथ उन्होंने काम किया, और एक बहुत अच्छा खूबसूरत काम उन्होंने आर डी बर्मन साहब के साथ भी किया था। दो तीन फिल्में उन्होंने उनके साथ की, और आज आर डी बर्मन साहब का बर्थ एनिवर्सरी है, आज जन्मदिन है उनका। तो हम कोशिश ये करेंगे कि इसी बहाने आर डी बर्मन साहब और खोसला साहब का एक साथ किया हुआ काम भी देखे, कुछ याद करें उनकी भी। आज के हमारे इस कार्यक्रम में राज खोसला साहब के लाइफ के बारे में, उनके काम के बारे में बातें करने के लिए, हमसे उस कई चीजों को उजागर करने के लिए बहुत गुणी और ज्ञानी विद्वान लोग हमारे बीच में आज मौजूद है। और मेरे साथ उनसे बात करने के लिए है वैदेही संचेती, जो कि एफटीआई की ही पास आउट है स्क्रीन प्ले राइटिंग की, और राइटर है खुद। तो मैं वैदेही से अनुरोध करूंगा कि हमारे आज के पैनल को इंट्रोड्यूस करें। प्लीज वैदेही, प्लीज गो अहेड। कोई बात नहीं, ऐसा हो सकता है, टेक्नोलॉजी का जमाना है, चीजें हो सकती है। ठीक है, तब तक मैं शुरू करता हूँ। हमारे साथ अभी शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा जी जुड़े नहीं है, कुछ देर बाद वो जुड़ेंगे। शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा जो कि एफटीआई के ही पास आउट है, एल्यूमिनस है, काफी सालों से फिल्मों में सक्रिय रहे हैं, और खोसला साहब की फिल्म भी उन्होंने एक प्रोड्यूस करी है, और उनके साथ 4 फिल्मों में काम भी किया था। तो सिन्हा साहब हमसे कुछ ही देर में जुड़ेंगे। हमारे साथ आज है हमारे सीनियर श्री राम राघवन सर, जो कि मुंबई से हमसे जुड़े हैं। श्री राम सर का एक अपना जॉनर है, काफी आज के तारीख के बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट फिल्म डायरेक्टर्स में इनका नाम शुमार है। और श्री राम सर के साथ हम बात करेंगे क्योंकि उनकी जो फिल्मों की लाइकिंग है वो खोसला साहब से होते हुए ही आगे निकलती है।
जी
तो बहुत बहुत स्वागत है आपका श्री राम सर। वेरी यूज योर माइक ऑन नाउ।
जी जी आई एम
थैंक यू,
सॉरी, कुछ
प्लीज कैरी ऑन।
हो नहीं पाया, माफ करें। सो वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग, और थोड़ी सी माफी तकनीकी खराबी के लिए। तो आगे हमारे जो मेहमान हैं उनसे मिलते हैं आज। खासकर हम लोग बहुत खुशकिस्मत हैं कि खोसला साहब के परिवार से उनकी बेटी अनीता खोसला, उनकी जो कि आज भी खोसला प्रोडक्शंस की प्रोप्राइटर भी हैं, वो भी हमारे साथ मौजूद हैं। उसी के साथ ही साथ जीएम कपूर साहब और उमा जी, जो उनकी दूसरी बेटी उमा जी खोसला, ये भी हमारे साथ मौजूद हैं दोनों लोग। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया और आप लोगों का बहुत बहुत स्वागत। इसी के साथ ही आप बहुत सारे लोग जानते भी होंगे और कुछ लोगों को नहीं पता होगा, तो खोसला साहब की बायोग्राफी, उनकी जीवनी पर काम चल रहा है और अनीता जी, कपूर साहब, उमा जी सभी लोग मिलकर इस जीवनी पर काम कर रहे हैं और इस जीवनी को लिख रहे हैं अम्बरीश रॉय चौधरी, जो खुद एक बहुत ही फिल्मों से बेहद प्यार करने वाले फिल्म बफ जिसे हम कहते हैं, साथ ही साथ फिल्मों के बारे में लिखने वाले, इन्होंने किताब लिखी है, कई विविध कार्यक्रमों में इन्होंने बहुत सारा उल्लेखनीय योगदान भी दिया है, वो भी मौजूद है। और आज एक और एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण व्यक्ति हमारे साथ मौजूद हैं, जो कि हमारे सबके चहेते शिक्षक भी, करण बाली जी, और हमारे काफी सीनियर फिल्म मेकर हैं, FTII के एलुमनाई रह चुके हैं और फिल्म डायरेक्शन के पास आउट है। हमारे बहुत प्यारे और चहेते शिक्षक हैं ये, क्योंकि आप विषय कोई भी उठा लें और करण जी के पास कुछ ना कुछ ऐसा कहने के लिए होगा जो आपने कहीं नहीं सुना होगा। तो बहुत बहुत स्वागत करण जी, और आपकी ढेर सारी प्यारी बातें सुनने के लिए हम लोग उत्सुक हैं। इसी के साथ एक विशेष मेहमान है हमारे साथ, जिनका योगदान हम देखेंगे कि कार्यक्रम में चार चांद जरूर लगाएगा, जो कि है कौशल इनामदार जी। कौशल जी मराठी इंडस्ट्री में म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर हैं, पर ये बहुत ही छोटी पहचान है उनकी। उन्होंने बहुत खूबसूरत फिल्मों में संगीत दिया है, जैसे बाल गंधर्व, अजंठा और मेरे ख्याल से येलो में भी, पर इससे कहीं ज्यादा प्यारी पहचान ये है कि उन्हें फिल्म संगीत, उसकी पेशकश, इस पूरे में उनका उनकी बहुत रुचि है, उनका बहुत अभ्यास भी है कि कैसे पेश किए जाते हैं गाने, कैसे बनते हैं गाने, और आज शायद वो हमारे साथ हारमोनियम पर कुछ पेश भी करें। सो अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम एवरीवन, वी आर जस्ट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अ वंडरफुल इवनिंग इन द मेमोरी ऑफ द ग्रेट मैन मिस्टर राज खोसला। ओवर टू यू मिलिंद जी।
यस, थैंक यू वैदे, थैंक यू वेरी मच। करण बाली सर के बारे में तुमने एकदम बहुत बेहतरीन बात कही है। कहीं पता नहीं हमें अलार्म न बजाना पड़े, जैसे क्लास खत्म होने के वक्त बजाना पड़ता है, क्योंकि करण बाली नहीं सर आपका है क्या, अभी पता चल ही जाएगा सभी को जैसे हम सुनने लगेंगे।
There are more learned people than me on this panel.
Yeah, नहीं, let's see. तो मैं पहला सवाल श्रीराम सर से करना चाहूंगा कार्यक्रम का आगाज करते वक्त। सर, राज खोसला साहब ने कई जॉनर्स पे काम किया, अलग अलग सब्जेक्ट्स को उन्होंने अपनी फिल्मों में से उसको एक अंजाम तक पहुंचाया, कई सारे अलग अलग विषय उन्होंने अपनी फिल्मों के सामने द्वारा लोगों के सामने रखे, और एक चीज जो उनके बारे में कही जाती है, जो कि जब भी सॉन्ग पिक्चराइजेशन की बात करी जाए तो चार पांच लोगों का नाम जो सबसे आगे लिया जाता है इंडिया में, जैसे गुरुदत्त साहब हुए, राज कपूर हुए, विजय आनंद हुए, उनमें एक नाम ये भी शुमार है जो है राज खोसला साहब। तो मैं ये कहना आपसे ये पूछना चाह रहा हूँ कि आज देखिए 30 साल हो गए, मगर आज भी राज खोसला साहब को ट्रिब्यूट की करके उनके काम को याद कर रहे हैं, तो आपको ऐसी कौन सी उनकी फिल्म याद पड़ती है जिससे आपका खुद का एसोसिएशन है, और जिस तरह का जॉनर आप खुद हैंडल करते हैं, तो खोसला साहब से आपका एसोसिएशन किस तरह से, यहीं से हम आज का हमारी चर्चा नहीं कह सकते ये एक एंटरटेनिंग चीज होने वाली है, इसको ज्यादा चर्चा के रूप में ना लिया जाए। यस, श्रीराम सर।
हाय मिलिंद, हाय एवरीबॉडी, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी हियर एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट अ बायोग्राफी इज बीइंग रिटन, और मैं कोशिश करूंगा हिंदी में भी बात करने की, ऐसा कुछ नहीं मैं बीच में हिंदी में भी घुस जाऊंगा। लेकिन मेरा एक्चुअली एसोसिएशन शुरू हुआ था राज खोसला साहब के साथ, एक्चुअली मैं शायद जब 10-12 साल का था, क्योंकि मैं पुणे में पैदा हुआ हूँ और मैं पुणे में मतलब पढ़ा हूँ वगैरह, और वहाँ पे उनके जो फिल्में जो मेरे बिफोर आई वाज बॉर्न या यू नो अर्ली, दे वर ऑल अवेलेबल ऑन बिग स्क्रीन इन मैटनी शोज, तो मैंने CID एंड 16 साल ये सब मैंने सिनेमा हॉल में देखे हैं, और उस टाइम तो हमको पता नहीं होता है कि मतलब फिल्म मेकिंग क्या होता है, किसी को वो मालूम भी नहीं कि मैं आगे जाके ये करने वाला हूँ वगैरह, लेकिन उनके फिल्मों में जैसे कुछ कुछ चीज़ें हैं, कुछ कुछ सीन्स हैं, कुछ कुछ या तो परफॉर्मेंसेज है या म्यूजिक है या ओपनिंग्स है या यू नो सीक्वेंसेस है, दो समहाउ स्टे एंड ग्रेजुअली एज यू सॉर्ट ऑफ गेट ओल्डर एंड गेट डीपर आई केम टू नो दैट I mean, Guru Dutt was his mentor, and he's, you know, in the company of Devanand and all these guys. I mean, there is a whole, they all sort of, you know, in one school of thought sort of thing, you know. They are, I mean, I can imagine them going to Metro and Regal and watching, you know, the American gangster films and things like that, and doing it in our own way with our romantic sort of approach, with a bit of the noir and everything. All this is so, for me, I mean, I cannot talk academically about Raj Khosla. I can just talk with a lot of, you know, love, you know. So I've seen, I mean, I've not seen all of his films because there are 2-3 family dramas I had sort of grown out of, you know. The last couple of films I was kind of, I have not seen. But I've seen about 20-22 of those films, of the films he's made, definitely. And I've seen them at least 7-8 times each. So you can imagine.
नहीं, ये जो एक एक्चुअली ग्रुप बना था मेरे ख्याल से, वो क्या दिन रहे होंगे, गुरुदत्त साहब, देव साहब, राज खोसला जी, विजय आनंद, एंड टुगेदर दे हैव क्रिएटेड सम ऑफ दैट मैजिकल पीरियड ऑफ हिंदी सिनेमा. करण सर, वुड यू लाइक टू एक्सटेंड ऑन दिस विथ रिगार्ड टू द जॉनर्स दैट आई वाज सीइंग यस्टरडे ओनली. आई जस्ट ऐड टू दैट, यस्टरडे ओनली आई सॉ नकाब वंस अगेन, एंड एक्चुअली इट कनेक्टेड मी टू वो कौन थी. तो इट्स द सर, आपका माइक.
It is actually a reworking of Woh Kaun Thi, but in a slightly different way. Woh Kaun Thi was a reworking, I think, somewhere of Wilkie Collins, I think, Woman in White. Whereas Nakab is actually a more faithful adaptation. The mystery parts are actually closer to Wilkie Collins, I think, book. But unfortunately, I think the great films that Mr. Khosla made in the 50s and 60s, Nakab, I think, came at a time when I think he was looking for success, and he actually, I think, went back to a film that had a basis in as one of his most successful films. But otherwise, ki jaise aapne kaha, I think what really makes him stand out is the sheer variety. I think maybe perhaps only Vijay Anand and Raj Khosla are two filmmakers who could straddle different kinds of filmmaking. I mean, he could do thrillers like CID. He could, the mystery trilogy with Sadhana, as we know, Woh Kaun Thi, Mera Saya, and Anita. An intense love story like Do Badan. A domestic melodrama like Do Raste. And dacoit dramas like Mera Gaon, Mera Desh, and also think Kacche Dhaage. Particularly Mera Gaon, Mera Desh, I think actually Sholay owes a lot to Mera Gaon, Mera Desh. Lot yes. of the plot points and things are actually taken from Mera Gaon, Mera Desh. Though Sholay had a wider success in terms of having its, as you know, what we say in Hindi cinema, the masalas were in the right proportion. But if you were to look at the focus of the story as a dacoit drama, I actually think Mera Gaon, Mera Desh is the tighter film, and it's actually the more coherent film of the two over there. It sticks to its story, whereas I think Sholay does branch out into its items, which okay have made it a thing legendary. And the other thing that I think the other couple of things that really think stand out with in Raj Khosla is in filmmaking. Ek to, the minute you're able to straddle a variety of genres, it means you're a very, very competent filmmakers handling different kind of scenes. Mm-hmm. Be it drama, be it the thriller, you know, element, it's all there. And then in terms of performances, I think he was particularly strong with actresses. In fact, he was known as the George Cukor of India. Because George Cukor in Hollywood was known for the performances. And when we kind of look at the kind of performances that, I mean, even in the later movies, Nootan in Main Tulsi Tere Aangan Ki, or Agar Hum Bombay Ka Babu Le, I think it's actually Suchitra Sen's most uninhibited performance on the Hindi screen. She was not so comfortable with the language, and there's a certain sense of things stiltedness, even when she's with Bimal Roy in Devdas or with Hrishikesh Mukherjee in Musafir. Mamta helped her out, I think, because she had already done the role once before. You know, so it was like dress rehearsal ho gaya, ab we are doing the final yeah, thing. But again, in Bombay Ka Babu, it's a very different Suchitra Sen, you see, one who's having fun. In a Hindi movies, one rarely saw Suchitra Sen having fun. She was very, I think, serious. But he did that in
role. बहुत serious ही रहे हैं मेरे
ख्याल. I mean, कि वो इतना बंबई का बाबू में, and of course, when the story gets serious, she's I think spot on. And there, I have to speak about the teaming of think Khosla Saab and Jal Mistry. I don't think I've seen better close-ups of an actress on the Indian screen. I mean, Suchitra Sen's close-ups are just ethereal, you know, in that movie. And of course, you have mentioned the songs.
नमस्कार, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, बहुत दिनों बाद
गोल्डन जुबली, ये डायमंड जुबली गोल्डन मेमोरीज के साथ
स्मरणांजलि, इसमें आप लोग सब मिले हैं और खासकर सबसे ज्यादा आज हम इकट्ठे हुए ट्रिब्यूट देने के लिए लेट एंड ग्रेट राज खोसला जी को, तो आज इस प्रोग्राम में आपने हमें शरीक किया है उसके लिए मैं आपका आभार प्रकट करता हूं। और साथ ही साथ श्री राम राघवन जी हैं, जितने लोग हैं यहाँ पे, कौशल जी हैं, बायोग्राफर ए राय चौधरी हैं, कि अनीता जी हैं, उमा जी हैं, जीएम कपूर हैं, उनके परिवार के लोग, राज खोसला जी के, सबको मैं ये मुबारक भी देता हूँ, बधाई देता हूँ, प्रणाम करता हूँ। और साथ ही साथ इस कार्यक्रम में शरीक होने के लिए सबको अपनी शुभकामना देता हूँ। हम भी आप लोगों की तरह राज खोसला जी के बहुत ही जबरदस्त प्रशंसक रहे। मेरा सौभाग्य रहा कि मैं उनके साथ एक नहीं, हालांकि उन्होंने 30 साल में करीब 26 फिल्मों में काम किया है, लेकिन मैंने उनके साथ 1, 2, 3, 4 फिल्मों में तो याद है मुझको, एक दोस्ताना फिल्म जिसका इतने बड़े म्यूजिक लवर थे, और मैं फिल्म मेकिंग और खासकर म्यूजिक के बारे में जो जानकारी राज खोसला जी को रही, शायद मेरा ख्याल है राज कपूर के बाद या चंद लोग और होंगे उनके बाद सबसे ज्यादा अगर किसी को रही है फिल्म मेकिंग और म्यूजिक दोनों के मामले में, वो राज खोसला जी को। और उनके साथ जो फिल्में की हमने, दोस्ताना की, जिसका वो गाना आज ही अमर है, सलामत रहे दोस्ताना, या फिर मेरा वो मेरा गांव मेरा देश, तो उन्होंने धर्म जी और विनोद खन्ना के साथ की थी, मेरे साथ किया था उन्होंने, मेरा दोस्त मेरा दुश्मन
जी,
फिर हाँ मेरा दोस्त मेरा दुश्मन, फिर माटी मांगे खून किया,
माटी मांगे खून भी,
हाँ वो भी किया। और जहां तक मुझे ख्याल है, मैं छोटा सा लेकिन बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट रोल किया था मैंने गेस्ट आर्टिस्ट का, वो शरीफ बदमाश हाँ ये सब फिल्में बहुत उनकी बहुत याद आती है। और फिल्मों के मामले में और ऐसे ह्यूमन बीइंग भी बहुत हंसमुख स्वभाव के, बहुत ही रिलैक्स। जनरली आप देखते हैं कि डायरेक्टर्स हमेशा बहुत टेंस रहते हैं सेट पे, लेकिन मैं सबसे ज्यादा रिलैक्स अगर किसी को देखता था तो राज खोसला जी को। और उनसे कई बार मेरे घर पे, उनके वहाँ पे जहाँ हम लोग बैठते थे, कई बार मुलाकातें होती थी। बहुत ही नॉलेजेबल, बहुत ही एक ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी इन टोटैलिटी वो, और उनसे हमेशा बहुत कुछ, इट वाज अ लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस, एवरी टाइम आई वर्क विथ हिम ऐसा लगता था कि उनसे बहुत कुछ सीख रहा हूँ, बहुत सीखना बाकी है। गानों का जहाँ तक जिक्र किया हमने, चाहे CID का जिक्र करें, या दो बदन हो, या नैना बरसे रिमझिम रिमझिम हो, या मुमताज के ऊपर पिक्चराइज किया हुआ आज तक का दी बेस्ट सॉन्ग बिंदिया चमकेगी, ये सारी फिल्में, सलामत रहे दोस्ताना हमारा वो गाना जो इतना सुपर हिट है और आज भी सुपर हिट है, वो अमिताभ और हमने मेरा ख्याल है 2 सिटिंग में की थी, एक दिन और 2 दिन नहीं, भाईदास हॉल में, और बच्चे आए थे वहां पे, और 2 सिटिंग में, और कितना बढ़िया सिंपल टेक्निक। वो जूम बहुत अवॉइड करते थे, जो हमारे FTII के लोगों को भी जूम ज्यादा पसंद नहीं आता है, हमने भी वहीं सीखा था ये, लेकिन टेक्निक के मामले में मैंने राज खोसला जी को देखा, एकदम मिड लॉन्ग शॉट पे ज्यादा जोर होता था, फिर क्लोजअप पे और खासकर हीरोइंस के मामले में। बाकी तो आप लोग बात करेंगे, मैं सुनूंगा। मैं तो आज शरीक हुआ हूँ अपनी श्रद्धांजलि देने के लिए उनको, उनको ट्रिब्यूट्स के लिए, उनके बारे में सुनने के लिए और उनके बारे में और जानने के लिए। मैं फिर आपका शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू यू, इंडेबटेड टू यू कि विद एन एटीट्यूड ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड राज खोसला जी के बारे में मुझे, राज खोसला जी के साथ काम करने का इतना मौका मिला, और मैं इन एटीट्यूड ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड के साथ मैं उनको प्रणाम करता हूँ, उनको याद करता हूँ, और वो हमेशा गुरु रहेंगे। जैसे FTI को मैं हमेशा अपना गुरु मानता हूँ, FTI के तमाम लोगों को अपना गुरु भाई मानता हूँ, उसी तरह से फिल्मों की दुनिया में जहाँ मैं राज कपूर साहब का सबसे बड़ा प्रशंसक रहा हूँ, दीवाना था, दीवाना हूँ और दीवाना रहूँगा, उनसे इतना इंस्पायर्ड मोटिवेटेड हुआ, वहीं दूसरी तरफ बहुत कम लोग हैं जिनमें से एक राज खोसला हैं जिनसे बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला, उनको करीब से जानने का सौभाग्य मिला, और आज इसके लिए मैं इस कार्यक्रम के लिए आप तमाम लोगों का एहसान मंद हूँ। थैंक यू वेरी मच। अब आप प्रोसीड करें और मैं सुनता हूँ।
शुक्रिया सर, बहुत ही अच्छा लगा आपकी बात सुनकर। बस जब आप आए तब हम बस थोड़ी सी बात श्री राम जी और करण जी दोनों ने करी थी कि किस तरह के दिग्दर्शक थे या उन्हें किस तरह से उनका काम किस तरह से इन्होंने देखा, क्या पसंद आया। तो मैं जरा सा बस थोड़ा सा पीछे जाना चाहती हूँ कि जितनी बार हम राज खोसला जी के बारे में सुनते हैं तो सुनने पढ़ने में आता है कि गायक थे, गायक बनना चाहते थे, और एक बहुत खूबसूरत आवाज और एक सहगल साहब को सुनते हुए अपनी गायकी को बनाते हुए बड़े हुए थे, और
फिल्म बहुत अच्छे गायक थे, बहुत अच्छे गायक,
और फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में आए भी इसलिए थे कि मैं गाऊंगा। और फिर वहां से लेकर के मैं अनीता जी से खास करके पूछना चाहती हूँ, और अम्बरीश आप भी, आपने भी कुछ ढूंढा होगा कि कहाँ से ये सफर, एक गायक का सफर एक निर्देशक बनने तक का जो सफर है, वो मेरे ख्याल से 1950 के आसपास ये सारी चीजें हुई होंगी, वो एडी भी रहे गुरुदत्त साहब के, तो ये किस तरह से हुआ, अगर उन्हें कुछ पता हो तो हमारे साथ जरूर साझा करें। अनीता जी और फिर अम्बरीश आप भी, क्योंकि आप आजकल इस पर काम कर रहे हैं।
अनीता जी आपका माइक।
Hello, my grandfather, yes, my grandfather, that is my his father, used to enjoy hearing him sing K.L. Saigal songs, because he had the, he felt it was very close to K.L. Saigal's voice. So he used to encourage my father to sing all his songs, I think, and he used to enjoy it so much that my father just got into the process of singing wherever he used to go. He used to have the harmonium and he used to be sitting down with his friends and he used to be singing. So the encouragement started right from home. Ambroish, you can...
Yeah, sure. Mera namaskar sabko pehle to. Yahan bahut bade bade diggaj baithe hain. Main to sirf film fan hoon. And I write and research a little bit about films. So Raj ji ka music ke hawale se... What I can say is, मदन मोहन जी ने जब अपना अपनी करियर की शुरुआत की थी विद अ फिल्म कॉल्ड आंखें, वी ऑल नो अबाउट हिज एसोसिएशन विद लता जी, बट आंखें में उन्होंने जिन सिंगर्स को लिया था उसमें जो सबसे आज वेल नोन नाम है वो राज खोसला है। आंखें में देयर वाज अ सॉन्ग कॉल्ड रेल में जिया मोरा सना नाना, दैट सॉन्ग इट स्टिल एग्जिस्ट, ये गाना राज जी ने गाया था। और इसके बाद दो तीन और गाने गाए थे, जो अंदाज फिल्म है महबूब खान की, उसमें एक गाना जो मुकेश जी ने गाया था वो गाना इट एग्जिस्ट इन LP रिकॉर्ड राज जी के वॉइस में, बट समहाउ आई डोंट नो व्हाट हैपेंड, आई डोंट नो व्हाई इट वाज नॉट इंक्लूडेड, बट वो गाना है, रिकॉर्ड हुई थी। इसके बाद फिल्मों में एक बड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग छोटा सा ट्रिविया ये है कि प्रेम कहानी करके एक फिल्म आई थी राजेश खन्ना और मुमताज जी, वहां पे एक छोटा सा सीक्वेंस है वेयर राज खोसला जी सिंग्स इन द वॉइस ऑफ राजेश खन्ना, बेसिकली राजेश खन्ना इज हमिंग, एक शेर है छोटा सा, वो राजी बोलते हैं एंड इट्स एज इफ इट्स राजेश खन्ना'स वॉइस एंड ही सिंग्स एग्जैक्टली लाइक KL Sehgal
साहब जी.
इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल ब्यूटीफुल सॉन्ग. इट्स अगेन देयर ऑन YouTube इफ एनीबॉडी वांट्स टू.
Amrish, should we see that?
Sorry?
And after that, should we see that, mom? So yes, that yes, you can hear sure. the voice also?
Sure, we can.
Of Raj Khosla.
Yeah.
Yes. I will just present that.
सो लाइक अनिता जी, आपने जैसे कहा कि KL Sehgal जी की साहब सहगल साहब की आवाज से काफी प्रेरित उसी तरह की गायकी.
एंड सहगल साहब के वो बड़े मुरीद थे. एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट बहुत सारी फिल्मों में उन्होंने सहगल साहब की आवाज यूज किया है एज अ पार्ट ऑफ द प्लॉट. दो रास्ते में है एक बंगला बने रहा. फिर नूरजहान जी का वॉइस भी बहुत सारी फिल्मों में उन्होंने यूज किया. ही वाज अ बिग फैन ऑफ सहगल साहब विच शोज इन हिज सिंगिंग स्टाइल आल्सो.
तो ये मेरा वही जैसे हमने कई बार सुना है कि ज्यादातर लोग फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में उस दौर के खासकर एक्टर बनने आते थे ज्यादातर लोग. और फिर एक्टर से जैसे मुझे लगता है तलत साहब भी इसी तरह एक्टर बनने आए थे, मुकेश साहब भी एक्टर बनने आए थे और फिर गायक बने. तो वो एक ट्रांजिशन मेरी समझ में आता है. बट आप गायक बनने आए हैं और ऐसा आप में देव साहब, ये प्रचलित है कि देव साहब ने उन्हें लाया. दोनों एक ही पिंड के थे, मुझे कपूर साहब ने कल बताया, गुरदासपुर के ही थे और वहीं से फिर कुछ हुआ. और ये किस तरह से गुरदत्त साहब के असिस्टेंट बने और फिर एक सफर शुरू हुआ. मेरे ख्याल से बाजी आर पार दोनों में मिलिन जी है ना, दोनों में असिस्ट भी किया है. तो ये बड़ा ही आई फाइंड इट वेरी इंट्रीगिंग. अमरीश,
yes, absolutely. Ye, there are fragments of the story available in various places. Raji, it's an irony ke unke upar aur zyada material available nahi hai. Bahut sari kahaniyan hame Gurudatt ke biography ke through jo Abrar Alvi sahab ki kitab hai aur baki jo Naseer Munni Kabir ke ek documentary hai usme Raj sahab ka ek chota sa bite bhi hai. So I think Raji used to frequent this place called Coffee House. These are all different stories from different sources. So we are still trying to validate a lot of these things. So apparently there was this place called Coffee House where a lot of Punjabi artists used to visit and haunt. So during those times, Raji got acquainted with Dev Saab. Dev Saab bhi wahin pe aate the aur ye log wo pind ka jo definition hai, like we were discussing, like pind ka definition is really expanded, so it can be your neighboring village also. To kyunki dono Gurdaspur zile se the, they bonded really well and both were very sophisticated, well read people. Raji was obsessed with Shakespeare. He used to read Shakespeare all the time. He had the entire collection. Dev Saab was this suave, sophisticated, westernized gentleman. So they got along really nicely, and I think it was Dev Saab who introduced Raji to Gurudatt, and that I think was the time where I mean everybody knows about the friendship of Gurudatt and Dev Saab and how they had started kind of collaborating together. Usi samay pe Dev Saab ne Gurudatt ke saath introduction karwaya tha Raj ji ka, and that is how Raji started assisting him. ये अगेन दीज थिंग्स आर नॉट वैलिडेटेड येट. हमने शुरुआत की है. वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन, अ लॉट ऑफ स्टोरीज अबाउट हाउ दिस एसोसिएशन बिगैन. बट अभी तक का जितना इन्फॉर्मेशन हमें दिखता है उसमें यह है कि देव साहब ने इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया था और उसी से बाजी, जाल और बाज, ये सारी फिल्मों में ही असिस्टेड हिम. एंड गुरुदत्त वॉज ऑलमोस्ट इंस्टेंटली इनैमर्ड बाई राजी टैलेंट एंड how he picked up the skill of filmmaking and everything associated with production, that it didn't take him very long. It took him, I mean, all these films were late 40s, early 50s. And it didn't take Gurudatt very long to pass on the baton of a director to Raj ji. So I think both Dev Saab and Gurzat Saab were very confident about Rajiv's skills as a director, which is why they gave him the opportunity. So I think that's how he kind of got into filmmaking or started making films.
I think पूरे समय राज साहब ने हमेशा से ही गुरुदत्त साहब को गुरु मानते हुए उनको हमेशा से उनका जिक्र भी आता था हर जगह पे और वो कहते भी थे कि स्पेशली व्हेन इट केम टू सॉन्ग पिक्चराइज
या तो
आई थिंक इट इज टाइम टू सी दैट स्मॉल क्लिप
एंड या आई थॉट सो यस श्योरली
योगेश कैन यू प्लीज प्ले दैट 37 आरके अपडेटेड
Okay, yeah. So this is a clip from a documentary which is a tribute to Gurudat Sahab.
The one that he was referring, made by Nasreen Munni Kabir.
Ji.
So there is a reference and I think it is a good time to just see what Raj Khosla Sahab is saying. And we have just extended it a bit because he is also explaining what happened over CID and at the Worli sea face.
I'm known for my song pictureization, that I pictureize songs very well. Actually, it's Gurdat and his skill that I learned.
दिल है मुश्किल जीना यहाँ जरा हट के जरा बच के ये है बॉम्बे मेरी जान.
Devanand, he tells me, this is Raj, what am I doing in this song? As the song is doing everything, you just walk. So the song goes through in its entirety for about 3 minutes or so, and he keeps walking. So after a few shots, he says, you want me to walk a mile or two or something? What am I doing in this song? I say, you're walking. You're not going to sing. I said, okay, you're the boss. He had the habit of always using his hands, you know. Somewhere that you don't move your hands. He says, I can't sing. I can't move my hands. I'm supposed to walk. I says, that's it. You're just supposed to walk and look handsome.
Lovely, lovely clip.
Yeah.
For these things, I am very thankful to YouTube.
Yeah, true, totally.
Lovely. Really lovely.
Gets us on these things.
Milind, shall we bring answer in?
Song picturization is one thing, but what's also interesting is that when Khosla Saab joined Gurudat Saab and with Bazi, Gurudat was also courting Geeta Dutt at that point of time. And they used to often go for picnics. This Lalita Lajmi has told me. They used to often go for picnics driving to Khandala, where they would actually take Geeta Dutt's car. She was the big star that time. Gurudat was still coming up. So they would go in her car, and because you could not go alone, the chaperones were Lalita Lajmi and Raj Khosla Sahab. And while they used to drive, the singing on the way in the car, as people sing in picnics, was done by Geeta Dutt and by Khosla Sahab out there.
Wow.
So he was kind of involved in their romance as well. Guru and Geeta Dutt were courting each other. Actually, what I was saying about his films, even before coming to songs, is I think one thing is, I also rate Khosla Saab very, very high in terms of his film craft. In terms of technique, I think what Vijay Anand and I think Khosla Saab gave to our cinema in the 1960s was a more dynamic sense of shot taking. Sure, we had good shot taking from the filmmakers that mattered in the 50s, but I think a stronger dynamism came in, and the fluidity of the camera movement and the camera tracks, especially I think came in with as they blossomed in the 1960s, and as Heething mentioned that obviously having worked with a master like Gurudat, obviously song picturizations was a legacy he sort of, as he says, inherited from there. But I also think what he inherited, and he also speaks about this, that he inherited from Gurudat Saab was the right use of close-ups. Like what Alfred Hitchcock said in the West, what Gurudat also felt was that true acting is in the eyes. And this is something that you see in both the Gurudat films and in the Khosla Saab's films, that at the key points in dramatic scenes, you have the right close-up at the right time. So I think there's also, it's not merely that he told stories along various genres or the picturized songs, I mean, really well. I think he had a very, very strong sense of film craft in his movies. And this, I think, is very, very apparent when you actually see Vokonthi, okay, which is actually one of his most, famous movie. And then you see the two remakes which were done. In Tamil, it was called Yarni, Who Are You? And in Telugu, it was called Ame Evaru, like, Who Is She? Now, both these movies actually were literally frame-to-frame copies of Vokonthi. And in fact, the song tunes were used also. The same songs were used in the Tamil and Telugu versions. And the situation is also very similar in Lag Ja Gale. The way Sadhana lies on the sand, Jayalalitha, who did both the Tamil and Telugu version, lies on the sand out there. But if you see the lighting, it's so much flatter in the Tamil version. Whereas the cage, Kapadia, along with Khosla Saab, it is so beautifully lit with low-key lighting. It adds to Sadhana's mystery. It adds to the confusion that Manoj Kumar is going through. And the use of those hanging roots, the way he makes things, Sadhana walk so that, you know, her face is always within light, it's covered with that. And of course, the sense of mystery that Thing Sadhana generated, I think, was much more than what actually in the South. Jayalalitha looks more the romantic heroine rather than the mysterious one. And in fact, I also remember reading in an interview where Thing Sadhana ji said that she and the Khosla Saab spent so much of time trying to find the right smiles for every situation in Vokonthi, that how mysterious should she be, how romantic should she be, etc. And again, talking of songs, it's a very well-known incident that, you know, one song that he filmed in the movie, he actually filmed with Madan Mohan's voice on Sadhana, you know, for Naina Barse Rimjhim Rimjhim. The song was not recorded with Lata ji, but they had to shoot the song. And even Sadhana mentioned in an interview ki the public around was laughing and they said, ye kaisi film hai, ye to hit ho hi nahi sakti, ek aurat ek aadmi ki awaaz mein ga rahi hai. Then of course, ki Lata ji, I think, came and dubbed, and the rest is, I think, history. But yeah, as I said, the songs is one thing which really makes him stand out, but I think he's not got enough credit for his film craft over there. It's not really that, you know, these were successful films in different languages. It's his film craft. His, I think, shot-taking ability, the dynamism he brought, especially the dramatic track-ins and track-outs.
Yeah, the track-ins and track-outs.
At times, you can actually feel that his focus pullers have struggled in the shots. They've gone a little out of focus while while it's been, you know, it's been tracking in. But he uses it very dynamically to move into his characters and out. And this is something we see in Gurudath as well. The track-in and the track-outs are a very integral part. If you look at his, I think, song like Jaane Wo Kaise Log The Jinke, you will see that, how it's been used. And then when you look at, I think, Khosla ji songs, you see the track-in and the track-outs.
Right. So, shall we take a... That was a very interesting discussion. We'll continue on the directorial thing, but I think this is just the time to look at the song, Milinji. Beautiful.
Karan sir, you want to say something on this?
Yeah, I think I pretty much, spoke earlier, but it's a beautiful picturization out there. Yeah. Totally. The entire, and especially when you're watching the movie, the mood that it creates, it's absolutely, you're actually as confused as Manoj Kumar is in his shoes as to what to make of Sadhana, because he's seeing her in different avatars, but she's been so beautifully presented. And as I said, it's the low lighting also that's kind of helped over there, and also the use of those roots, the palms that, you know, fit across her face. We see Manoj Kumar walking through darkness and light. It's almost his mental state of mind that is being represented, through that picturization over there. We see beautiful use of the crane as she gets up, that the camera moves with her, other things showing. I don't know, it's just beautifully conceived. And especially when we see these older movies, I think hats off to these filmmakers, because they did not have a video assist
then.
to even to see what they're shooting. They actually imagined it and they had to wait and see the rushes to see, and they had to go and they had to go by the words of the DOP and really had to trust the DOP as to what was the okay take and think over
totally. That's another, and, that's a very difficult thing to do. I mean, that's a very difficult thing for students of these times to even think of.
Yeah, absolutely.
You
know, and also, and as I said,
spot on, I think, with your craft.
And also in the work on, like I said, he was very good with actresses. And actually, all three of the military, I mean, the mystery trilogy, it is Sadhana who's the life of the three movies. He work on the, I think, Mera Saya. And of course, Sunil Dutt is great as the dedicated husband, but she's the life of the movies. And he was very, very strong in this right from the beginning, even in Solva Saal. Again, a very unusual story of one night, it, you know, where this girl
elopes from... Allow me to interrupt. I just want to say a small... Allow me to interrupt, please. So another aspect here, I thought, is ki wo dono kirdaron ke man mein kya chal raha hai. और वो कौन सी जैसे आपने कहा कि द लाइटिंग इज शोइंग कि उसके दिमाग में क्या चल रहा है वो ही इज नॉट श्योर वेदर दिस इज ट्रू वेदर दिस इज अ मिस्ट्री व्हाट इज हैपनिंग पर वो गानों के थ्रू हमेशा उनके सारे गानों में रहा है कि जो सिचुएशन है वो गाना सिर्फ गाने के लिए नहीं है वहां पर जो किरदारों के मन में चल रहा है वो गाने की लिरिक्स से ही निकल करके आ रहा है जैसे यहाँ पे बोल रही है पासा ही तो वो बस अब गाने का सिचुएशन मूड बन गया तो हमने गाना
To filmmakers like Gurudat, Raj Kharoor Saab, Vijay Anand Saab and thing, the song was a very, very integral part of the plot. And when they created the song situation, they built to, you know, to that song. The scenes led to it. There's a dialogue exchange and a build-up to this song where the, you know, where then she comes out with Lag Jaa Le. And in their movies, we'll see, there's usually a proper build-up to that song so that that song is a very integral part of the thing story. It's not like, you know, what had really happened in the 80s in a very big way. For example, Himmat Wala mein, Shridevi lies on the bed, imagines, and we, you know, cut to Naino mein somehow. But here the filmmakers, be it Khosla Saab, be it Vijayan, they built up to their songs. Their songs became a natural expression then of what the characters were, you know, going through. So, they took it very seriously.
Yeah, I'd like to also bring in Ambarish here. Ambarish, we were making some observations about another such piece where storytelling is happening through the song. I think we should talk about that now.
Yeah.
Mera Gaon Mera Desh.
Yes.
Mera Gaon Mera Desh.
There is this song in Mera Gaon Mera Desh where Lakshmi Chhaya is supposed to be an informer who is supposed to tell the cops where Vinod Khanna, who is Jabbar Singh, where is he standing and what is he wearing because he's in a disguise. So, gaane ka lyrics aisa hai that, I mean, it talks about love and different stages of love, but actually, she is saying ki uske pagdi ka rang kya hai, kurte ka rang kya hai, kahan pe ped ke niche khade hai. So, all of this is actually told through song. So, what Karanji was saying about pushing the narrative forward, here it was literal gaane se actually kahani batai ja rahi hai and an essential part of the song
of the leela kurta nahi yahan pe mujhe ek jo cheez abhi hum baat kar rahe hai ki director to is the in command or is we say captain of the ship and things like that to wo to lead karta hi hai magar yahan pe ek aisa director hai jo ki khud music janta hai gaata hai is a good harmonium player ek musafir ek haseena mein to wo harmonium I think let us request Kaushal to talk about how the association with the music director must have been. And different directors, we just had Madan Mohan's tune. So Kaushal, could you just elaborate on how this must have happened? There is another movie of Madan Mohan immediately followed by in Mera Saya. Kaushal?
Yeah. Okay. So let me... begin by saying that I am really honored to be a part of this esteemed panel. Actually, it's very embarrassing also because I don't think I'm really suitable to be here. It's like, you know, Dilip Vengsarkar was asked when he joined the Indian cricket team, what is going to be to your advantage after your selection? So he said, now I'll get to watch a test match from close quarters. So the same thing is happening to me. I'm getting to watch these people talk from very close quarters and a front row seat. So the price I have to pay is actually you have to pay is to listen to me. First thing, you know, in my Facebook bio, I have written that I am a storyteller in the guise of a musician. I think it's the DNA of these filmmakers that we are carrying. And about Rajji, I feel it's exactly the opposite. He was a musician in a guise of a storyteller. His songs were telling stories that is, you know, that anybody can see. But his shot taking, his filmmaking, the characters, the story that he was telling was actually music. It had the sublime flow of, you know, a song being composed. And I've observed some very peculiar things about the songs in Rajji's films. It happens if a director knows music, and whatever little films I have done, I have experienced. If the filmmaker knows music, then he imposes a lot. His personality is imposed on the music of that film. And that has happened even in case of Raj Kapoor films or Subhash Ghai's. Their personality, you can see the personality of the director in the film. Okay. Now, in Rajji's, the exact opposite has happened, is that you see the rate of success of music in his films, and you'll see, yet Madan Mohan is Madan Mohan's best. Lakshmikant Pyarelal is Lakshmikant Pyarelal's best. R.D. Burman is R.D. Burman's best in Rajji's movies. He does not himself impose his personality on his music. In fact, he gets the best out of what that music composer is capable of. And that is a fantastic thing. I mean, I was so overjoyed and disappointed at the same time. Overjoyed because you see a film director like that, and disappointed because I was not doing music in his times. You know, that was a big disappointment.
That's such a beautiful thing to say, Kaushalji. That's so beautiful. Thank you.
So it was, you see, for example, CID, you see, it's the brand of music is definitely Open Air or Ek Musafir Ek Haseena. And there, it's like Rajji's personality in getting the music done is like water. He just allows the color of that musician to flow on his films, which is such a fantastic quality, because I think it adds to the versatility of his storytelling. If the music of Woh Kaun Thi was done by S.D. Burman, perhaps the picturization would have been different, is what I feel. Now, this is just conjecture, but because he went into the flow of how the music was given, not something that he wanted would be in the music, but you see Bombay Ka Babu, you see quintessential S.D. Burman. For example, in Chalri Sajni, the second thing that I observed was that his penchant for creating time in his stories with music. So there would be at least one or two songs in the film which would create time. For example, Lag Ja Gale in Woh Kaun Thi. And as Karanji rightly said, there is that Manoj Kumar comes out of shadows into the light, then from the light goes into the shadows. Sadhana Ji's face is covered sometimes with shadows and the branches of the trees or the shadow of the trees. He has used the same technique in many songs to display the inner mental state of the protagonist. For example, in Bombay Ka Babu, also the opening song where Devanand is confused as to where he has come and what he doesn't know what exactly to expect. you see Babu Chinnanna, the song, there are a lot of frames where the face of Suchitra Sen is covered. It's not entirely visible. Or there are some frames which run through windows. So you have obstruction on the face. And that is, I think he has used it a lot of times. I've seen even in Chirag, in the solo song of Muhammad Rafi, I don't remember the song, but Sunil Dutt's face when he's actually in a very emotionally unstable state. At that time, you see the song is picturized through the windows, not directly. His face is not shown directly, or even if it is shown, the pension.
As you have mentioned Chirag,
yeah,
could we just hear a bit of Chirag?
Yeah. So this is a song.
Good.
What I meant by getting the best of the music composer. Okay, so this is Madan Mohan. Teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai? Ye uthe subah chale, ye jhuke shaam dhale. Mera jeena, mera marna inhi palkon ke tale. Now, if you see these two lines only, if you take, it's the best storytelling that he's got done by a music composer. For example, the lyric, "Teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai?" It's a question.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. But it's not a question that is supposed to be answered. It's a rhetoric. "Teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai?" is not a question which is supposed to be answered. Like, you know, you go to a railway platform and go to the inquiry counter and ask, when is the next train coming? Then you expect an answer. But teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai? Inherently, it has the answer that there is nothing apart from your eyes. Okay?
Sawaal hai jisme jawab pehle se hi hai.
Jawab hai. Inherent jawab hai usme. Abhi, the intelligence of Madan Mohan and by association Rajji also, is that how he gets the composition. If it's a question and it comes to, this is the sa. Sa. Sa is the bass note of a song. Okay? So if I end, teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai? So sarega, it's not a settled question, right? It's, I'm expecting the answer if it's on G. Unless I get it to Sa, you won't feel settled. So what does Madan Mohan do? Teri aankhon ke siva duniya mein rakha kya hai Sa.
Settled.
There is no discussion, settled. Nahin toh affair hi toot jata unka aur आशा पारिक जी का.
ये कैसा सवाल है? अगर ये सवाल रहता है, कैसा है
ये? क्यों सवाल पूछ रहे कि कुछ था या? Now the genius comes in the next line. ये उठे सुबह चले. अभी you know people say that we don't understand music. It's not so true. You understand music like you understand gravity. You know that things are coming down if you throw them up, right? So सारे गम पदनी. So nobody will say that this is coming down. When I say sare gama padhani sa, nobody say I'm coming down. Everybody will say you are going up. Sa nidha pa magare sa, nobody will say I'm going far. They will say I'm coming close. It's so that much you understand. Now what a music composer is doing is actually he is making use of what you understand to tell that story. So ye uthe subho chale, to uthe upar hai ke niche hai? ये उठे सुबह हो चले, झुके नीचे है या ऊपर है? ये झुके, बट शाम सुबह के आगे है. शाम ढले,
तो ये उठे सुबह हो चले, अगर सुबह गप है तो शाम हैज टू गो अहेड, ये उठे सुबह हो चले, ये झुके शाम ढले. नाउ द जीनियस इज इन दिस दैट मेरा जीना मेरा मरना. सो इफ द लोअर सा इज द बेस और इज द वेर यू सेटल इज योर होम, देन द ऊपर का सा will be the destination. So, mera jeena, mera marna. So, if that's the entire life, so what does Madan Mohan do is he encompasses the entire octave in these two words.
Two words.
And then, mera marna ending on the upar ka sa. Mera jeena, mera marna. Like, the lower sa is settling the question, the upar ka sa is also settling the question, but it's the ultimate destination, no? Mera jeena, mera marna. So it's like stopping at food mall, but not going till Pune.
Wo kaam nahi karega.
Mera jeena, mera marna. Where? Kaha? Inhi palkon ke tale sa. So coming, and this is the intelligence of every music composer that he has used in his different songs. So even Jaane Ke Baad Thi, perhaps we might talk about it later.
Yes. Yes, bilkul. Thank you so much. It was so beautiful listening to this, and yeah, I think that deserves a ovation from all of us.
Yeah, that was an eye opener.
Truly.
आप हमें बताएंगे कि बिकॉज ही यूज्ड टू प्ले हारमोनियम एंड सिंग, ही वाज इन लव विद फैज एंड lot other shires, in how it used to be at how, I mean, at your...
love again cycle, and that love came to all of us. Like, I still think Kel Cycle is one of the best singers. I love every song of his. I know all the wordings of every song and I enjoy them still. And music, you're saying, the music, how he, what was your question?
Yeah, how, like, we wanted to know, ki, jaise ghar mein, like, how would he be? How would a dinner at Khosla home be in the evening? Jaise aap log sab baithe hain aur baat ho rahi hai, kya baat ho rahi hai?
Many things together. Achha, the cook has to be a very good cook, and we have to have ghee with the ghee, you know, not just that thick thing, garam karke, put it in your dal, come on, all of y'all, and it made sure that that was there. Then, suppose one of us fought with each other and wouldn't eat or something, then he would say, call her, why is she not coming, there's that, make it all happy. And he used to give us gyan about cooking, okay, don't put too much salt. You always put it after it's cooked, whenever you eat, you know, things like that.
Yeah.
And he also told us that you don't have to have a very spreads and all that about food and all that. Just roti, sabji, chawal, dal, that's all. Because suppose later on in life, you don't get to have that luxurious food, you will not like it then, you know? Yeah. And we used to chat a lot, especially after the meal. It was so good. After the meal, we used to really have long chats. And that was lovely. And he used to make sure the cook makes a fantastic fish, mutton, this, that, everything.
Would he insist that you read a certain kind of books or watch a certain kind of film?
Yes, my
brother.
No. He always gave us that feeling that, you know, books like magazines, like say Illustrated Weekly. he never allowed any filmy magazine. Then he encouraged us to have all these, you know, these good authors, you know. I can't remember all the names. So that was that. And like he himself was a very good reader. In his office, he had William Shakespeare. He had so many other things about books. So it was like that.
Huh?
O. Henry Niyad.
Fond of O. Henry.
O. Henry.
That was one of his favorite authors also, because though all those you know, novellas or short stories always had a twist.
Gee, it would have a very interesting ending most of the time.
So he was very fond of that. And as I mentioned to you about A.L. Sehgal, I think I mentioned that as a young child, he used to watch K.L. Sehgal, you know, do his riyaz in their house next door on the terrace. And that's what he told me himself, that because of his devotion to listening to K.L. Sehgal every evening, K.L. Sehgal blessed him and said, told him that jaat bache tu jab bhi gayega meri awaaz mein gayega.
And that's what happened.
That actually happened. We actually heard the song as well. Wow, that's so nice. Yeah,
that was fab.
Yeah, that's very nice to hear. Just a little thing which I'd like to move on to with and ask Anita ji, like going a little away from the music for a while. Bear with me here. So when we were looking at the films that he has made, like there's one particular writer that he has stuck to, and which kind of I felt very amused by the fact that B.R. Kamath saab ke saath unhone for a long time kaam kiya. I think wo unke writer rahe bahut shuruaat se lekar lagbhag unki aakhri filmon tak bhi. So Anita ji se main Kamath saab ke bare mein dhoondne ki maine bhi bahut koshish ki, film ne bhi तो ज्यादा कुछ हमें मिला नहीं. तो किस तरह का ये एसोसिएशन था? बिकॉज इट्स वेरी अम्यूजिंग कि इतने लंबे समय तक दोनों ने मिलकर काम किया, बहुत सारी अलग अलग फिल्में दी. तो आप क्या आपने उनको देखा काम करते हुए? कैसा?
यू नो ड्यूरिंग मैं तुलसी आई वॉच्ड जी आर कामत, डॉक्टर राही एंड माई फादर सिटिंग इन द ऑफिस. दे यूज्ड टू गेट इन एट 1:30. And the lunch used to be sent into their room, and going on and on. At 4 o'clock, you'd have dropped in for some tea and just looking at them. And they're still working at it, they're still working at the story. Then 6 baj gaye, then driver aaya lene ke liye, again they're still working. 8 o'clock, they used to leave the office. 1:30 to 8 o'clock. Nobody would protest. Nobody. Everybody was so involved and so into making the scenes. You know, they worked very, very hard for Mai Tulsi, you know, very hard. Dr. Rahi, D.R. Kamath and my father, all three of them. And when I see the scenes and I see the way, you know, Dev Mukherjee acted, you know, it was quite a revelation, because, you know, he somehow brought out the best in the most ordinary actors. So I found that amazing, you know. He used to take on new people and he used to just do his magic on them. And the groundwork was so thorough. It was absolutely thorough.
Yeah.
That's what I saw.
Yeah, that's a very beautiful thing. It's a very nice point you're making here. Like, we've seen how Vinod Khanna ji has been kind of mounted or picturized with other directors versus Vinod Khanna ji with Raj Khosla saab. There's a very interesting thing to observe, but it's very different. So Amrish, would you like to talk about that and his handling of his
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Just a second, Amrish. Sure. Kapoor sahab, aap apna mic off karenge please?
Sir.
Thank you. Yes, Amrish, please.
Yeah, so his the way he showed Vinod Khanna and the kind of roles he gave him was very interesting. As a matter of fact, I was discussing Prem Kahani with Mumtaz ji. I was interviewing Mumtaz ji for the film. I was talking about her performance, which was very different and refreshing from a certain perspective, because usse pehle jo do raaste thi, which was a conventional heroine, but Prem Kahani, if you have seen, is a very different kind of a character, where I mean, how a woman character carries herself and actually goes out and proposes to the guy, and when he says no, she says good riddance. So it is a very interesting kind of role. So I was talking about her performance, and she was talking about Vinod Khanna's performance in the film. The interesting thing is, in Prem Kahani, Vinod Khanna had a cameo.
He
played this truck driver, good Samaritan called Sher Khan.
Right.
And he had a very interesting way of approaching a Pathan role. See, Vinod Khanna, when you look at Vinod Khanna's performances, he's not a very over-the-top animated kind of a performer. His performances are, even the louder dialogues, he looks slightly muted and, it's a kind of underperformance in a manner of speaking. So she was actually going gaga about Vinod Khanna ji's performance, and she was saying how the audience reacted to Vinod Khanna's performance in the film.
Hmm.
So there's that. There's, of course, Main Tulsi Tere Aangan Ki. There's Mera Gaon Mera Desh, the exceptional villain there, Daku Jabbar Singh, in his own way.
Right.
And a very underrated film called Kacche Dhage.
Kacche Dhage, of course.
Where I think Vinod Khanna was fantastic in that film. I mean, he had a very, very grey character, and grey is the right word, because he was neither the hero in the traditional sense, nor was he a conventional villain. It was a beautiful role. I don't know why people don't talk about it so much, or why didn't it do better than it did, but it's a great role. So I think Vinod Khanna and him had a certain kind of a chemistry, and he knew the strengths of all of these actresses, like Anita ji was saying about Deb Mukherjee and all of these people. Geeta Bell was present in many of his films. So all of these actors and actresses, he actually knew how to pull out the best from them.
The best out of them. Yeah, I guess that's the best thing about a director, to know those people and get it. So I'd like to bring Sriram in for a minute. Sriram, it's so we stick to a type of film, or sometimes we stick to a kind of subject. Here is a man kind of doing almost all genre, different kinds of stories, different star casts, so many big names. I mean, how does one get his head around all of that? Like, what do you make of all of this?
No, I think that's one of the sort of unique things about him. Like, and Karan said, Vijay Anand. You know, I mean, they just and they've got substantial movies in each of these genres. It's not just one by chance or something like that, you know.
Correct, yes.
If you take the noir, the early films, you know, I mean, CID and Solva Sal and the Bombay Ka Babu. I mean, these are films which are, some of them don't do well. Like Bombay Ka Babu apparently didn't do well because of the ending. But that is one of the greatest endings, of a movie. It's like, it reminds me of Third Man and stuff like that, you know, in the sense.
Totally.
And he is a filmmaker who like, okay, after that, the suspense movies. I mean, there I can tell you, like, because I was a kid, my mom used to see these movies before me. I mean, and I would never see them. I used to be told the story. Because, okay, we can't see the movie, and so you tell her this story. And she will, while she's doing some work, she will be telling it in fair amount of detail. So, all spoilers, okay. After a year or so, whenever I get a chance to play hooky or whatever, and I go to watch the movie, even though I know this is the story, this is the plot, it doesn't matter because it's still, that's why I say, I feel the mise-en-scene. Now, I'm not able to sort of analyze it in sense because I've not studied it recently, the films, you know. But as I remember, I mean, each one, like Kacche Dhage, for example, since Amrish was talking about it, that is one film just by chance. I mean, because Melinda told me, I said, okay, I've sort of, let me watch it. And I watched it one evening, like, you know, like you watch a movie. And I'm telling you, it holds till today. I mean, it holds till day, and that ending and everything is like you actually feel very sad at the movie, you know. And it's again a highly risky movie. I mean, right from the beginning, you know, these characters are bleak and they are like, you know, they have no chance, but it still completely sort of holds your attention. No, there's nothing as the Vinod Khanna's playing. It's a very, very grey character. And Mera Gaon Mera Desh, and surely they don't do it. In Mera Gaon Mera Desh, he shoots a kid in front of the mom, you know. And you wonder as a viewer, I remember even then when I was watching it, like, obviously they won't show this. Sort of in your head, it's almost there, you know, but it's shown. And you're like, and it's like, it's, I mean, in these things that he does now, I think are what things like we learn from filmmakers like that, you know. And one of my most favorite movies of his is not great in the critical list, maybe, Sharif Padmash. I don't know. I just love that movie. And I've seen it maybe because I'm a big fan of Devanand and the music and the everything. And it's like, I remember even the poster when the movie came out in the newspaper was, you know, this jail and this one man standing there. Was he a gangster in the garb of a good man? Or was he a good man in the garb of a gangster?
The garb of a gangster, yeah.
So as a kid, you're like, oh my God, I have to watch this movie. And funnily, because you watched it at a certain age and loved it, that love, whenever, even if I watch it now, I'll enjoy it. I mean, it will be, it's a highly crazy movie and kind of thing. It's got Shatrughan sir, I love that Rocky. He plays Rocky in that movie.
In that film, yes.
Okay. So I can just go on and on, but please, I mean, I'm enjoying listening to so many stories and so many things I didn't know about Raj Kushwai.
So another small thing that comes from what you just said, I mean, the characters all through his films, even in the noir or in the suspense films or in the family films, the characters that he has chosen to kind of tell his story, a lot of them are grey, which is also, I found them that a very interesting thing. And I would like to bring in Karanji here. That from those black and white films, even to the later films, a lot of stories which he has chosen is people who are grey.
People which is actually okay, which is actually true, because even like I was talking earlier of the Solva Sal, which is a one night story, but I think central character in it is actually a woman who is eloping with a guy.
Correct.
Yeah. And the love story happens.
Fine, I think. Yeah.
And the love story happens when the guy ditches her, and now your hero. He basically tries to get her home before her family, her dad realizes what she's done in the night.
What she's done, correct.
Again, it's a very, very interesting thing plot. And I have to actually confess that though I didn't do it, it was a script I did try reworking at one point of time in more contemporary thing. Think Solva Sal thing, because again, it was very, very interesting. Obviously, with the double role thing syndrome and also though in Anita, it's not really a double role, but where she's got... She's shown to have multiple personalities. He's able to use that many shades then for the characters. In fact, in Vokonthi and Mera Sai, in the Vokonthi more than anything else, the two sadhanas are very, the good sister and the bad sister, which is also a trope right from movies like Anhoni, when, you know, heroines had double roles. You had the good sister and the bad sister, even in Sharmili, for example. You had it. It is very distinct. Mera Saya is interesting because actually I wouldn't say the second sister is totally negative. It's more the mystery happens because she dies due to, you know, that accidental switch that happens.
Over
there. And again, in Anita, to create the mystery, there's a lot of grey to Sadhana's roles, at least in the way people describe her, until the truth comes out.
Correct.
And we ourselves, so yes, he did work with a lot of interesting characters which had the shades. But as I said, he was he had something special for the women, because even when he did Solva Sal, now it was Devanand at its peak. You have a young Wahida Rehman who just got CID and think Vyasa behind her. But the central character from beginning to end of Solva Sal is Wahida Rehman. The story is hers. Devanand is a helper in that sense. And, he helps her get home, of course. He's a hero in that sense. But the central character and the life of that movie is Wahida Rehman.
Yes.
Over
so,
there.
Nakab also, we have a double role of Farah.
Yeah, but again, that's a Vokonthi. I mean, Milton Collins.
Yes.
It's an adaptation. And even with the Vokonthi, only it's just an interesting fact, which I think most people will know. But just because we've spoken about his... relationship with being Guru Dutt Saab's, I think, assistant. Guru Dutt Saab was actually making a film called Raaz.
Raaz,
supposed to be Pancham's debut as well.
Yeah.
Absolutely. In fact, two songs were recorded, including a song on Three Notch Girls, which is actually sung by Asha Bhosle, Shamshad Begum and Geeta Dutt. Three great thing singers in that one song. And it was initially Sunil Dutt and then Guru Dutt, and Wahida Ji was playing the double role. And when Raaz got shelved, then I think somewhere, from mentor to the script shifted. But it was reworked by, I think, Khosla Saab's own way. It was not Raaz. From what one's heard from people and things, right? He then sat and reworked it his own way before he came out with Vokonthi over there. And again, the way he's used, I think, Sadhana is beautiful. in that movie.
And exactly. So my mind is going in two places, and I'm choosing to go back to a certain scene, and then we'll come back to Sadhana. Sure. Ji, it's too boggled here. So, Milind ji, can we play that scene while we are talking about grey characters? Kacche Dhage mein ek bahut hi khoobsurat scene hai jiska dhyan Ambarish ne hamara dhyan us par khicha ki let's watch that scene. It's a slightly different scene. So, shall we play that, Milind ji?
Yeah, we can.
This is the time to play that? Yeah, okay, great, thank you. Bahut hi pyara scene hai. I think most of us know the film, and let's watch the scene.
Pyara to nahi hai. It's not a pyara scene.
No, for no, me.
Nahi, see, mujhe.
You're right.
I was just listening. I've been in the backseat. I'm so happy to listening. See, the thing is that we have been talking about the different genres, but there are these values which have been there. Like, there is this sibling play. They are not brother sister, but it's there in Bombay Ka Babu. Similar thing happens in Kacche Dhage. So there is no hero heroine as such. Like the lead and the though they are leading characters, they are not hero and heroine in the traditional format. Did Kabir Bedi, Vinod Khanna, but Mausmi Chatterjee come after 1 hour 4 minutes.
Yeah,
so
true.
Female lead in the film. Yeah, Yogesh, are you playing that? Sorry, I didn't tell him.
So Kacche Dhage.
Play it after 45 seconds. Just move it further.
So in that Bombay Ka Babu song, it's almost incestuous, that whole representation, almost, or rather borderline, let's say. So, but that's also very interesting. It's two.
It's a fantastic scene, and actually, apart from Vinod Khanna, I think the very subtle expressions that flit across Nirupa Roy's face towards that, those silences speak so much. Mm-hmm. Like, again, so beautifully kind of handled and so beautifully done out there. Just very subtle emotions flitting across her face.
I think in Mother India, Vastav, so many films, the mother, the quintessential ideal mother has always been questioning the son who has become a monster. But this is probably the only film where Raji actually made the son shot back and respond. Although the circumstances are very different, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, but it takes quite a lot of courage to have a scene like that and play out that.
Yes.
कोई subtlety नहीं रखी वो बात में कि आपने मुझे डाकू बनाया और उस डाकू को मैंने पशु बनाया. तो बिल्कुल साफ साफ कि what were you expecting? और क्या होने वाला था? आपने मुझे बंदूक दिया हाथ. But इसे करने के लिए भी courage चाहिए to keep it like that and you know.
Yeah, amazing. So, Mera Gaon Mera Desh ke baad, one would assume that he was repeating a Daku film again because the earlier film had worked. But if you look at it, Kacche Dhage was a very risky film, to execute. Both the characters and the way the characters navigate through. Mausmi ji ka character is a heroine, but not a heroine. Hmm. Vinod Khanna and Kabir Bedi are heroes, but not heroes.
There's
Ritesh Kumar in the middle of it all. Hemant Kumar's son, who is just there for the songs and everything. So it's phenomenal, and like how Shidamji was saying, the ending of the film. So it is very extremely unconventional. I'm surprised he made it when he did, because it was a very unconventional choice.
Yeah, true, totally. And so Milindji, let's go back a little bit. Na, hum Sadhana ji ki baat karna chahte hain ki Sadhana ji ke saath unhone bahut sari filmen kari. I think almost four films.
And there was a fifth incomplete one also, incomplete, which is almost ready by 90, I think percent, called thing Sajan Ki Galiyan, Devanandana, and which he was making in color actually. And again, some beautiful close-ups of Sadhana that one has actually seen the few couple of scenes that, you know, which are part of this film called Film Hi Film, where we saw scenes from incomplete movies. And there's a beautiful romantic scene between Devanand and Sadhana. Which is there from Tik Sajan Ki Galiyan. And I've seen one song, actually parts of two songs from the movie. But otherwise, I think among the work that Sadhana has done, if you have to count her finest work, it's actually divided between the two films that she did with Bimal Roy, that is, you know, Prem Patra and Tik Parak. Mm-hmm. And I think somewhere her work for, I think, Raj Khosla. Right. The mystery trilogy is unthinkable without her. It's like she's literally made each of those roles her own.
Correct.
You know, and you actually feel ki no one could play the mysterious woman better than her.
Bilkul.
Absolutely. And And since those roles had, I think, various shades, I think they also brought out her skill as an actress. Unfortunately, again, like I said, I think Khosla Saab has not been given his due, even by film historians. I'm not talking of new generations today, but even film historians, when they talk of the golden age of Indian cinema, I think his Sadhana has not got her due as an actress. It was always the Sadhana cut and the tight kurta and chudidar and mojaris that took everyone's attention away. And over there, and I think three of her finest performances are Woh Kaun Thi, Mera Saaya, and Anita. I mean, with the Sajan Ki Galiya, one can only wistfully, looking at those scenes, imagine what might have been. And especially when apparently those movies are almost complete. Apparently, it was 80-90% complete. All the bigger tragedy. But again. Not just in Sadhana. I think Asha Parekh was, in fact, first noticed as an actress with Do Badan.
Just a minute, Karanji. So I want to bring in Anita ji a little bit here because Anita ji, how was this particular relationship, this friendship? I think it extended beyond just being a director and an actor. It was more than that. What would you say?
Yes, absolutely. Sadhana was a very cultured person and I had gone for dinner with my dad to Landmark, where she and her husband had hosted us. And she was speaking so beautifully and, the whole atmosphere was so nice. And earlier also, she had recommended her niece's college for me and my sister. So my sister did go to that college, St. Bede's in Simla. And somehow she's always been there. And even after he passed away, she wanted to keep in touch.
It was
lovely. I mean, another thing is for Sunny, she gave her bungalow for shooting, a whole song.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's so nice.
Yeah.
With the films, the number of films that he did and also with the lot of different actors that he worked with, also the productions. मतलब वो खुद भी producer भी थे और producers के लिए भी काम किया. और बहुत छोटे समय में बहुत बहुत ज्यादा बहुत अच्छा बहुत लंबा काम किया. तो आई थिंक ही वाज आल्सो कंसीडर्ड एज अ बैंकेबल डायरेक्टर विथ हु वुड कम अप विथ काइंड ऑफ स्टोरीज लाइक धर्मा वी सी टुडे बट द फर्स्ट फिल्म वाज लॉन्च बाय राज खोसला साहब.
बिल्कुल.
खोसला इज धर्मा प्रोडक्शंस फर्स्ट फिल्म एंड देयर आर मेनी अदर्स लाइक इफ यू सी सनी और मे बी ही आल्सो हेल्प सुनील दत्त साहब ऑन रॉकी.
On Rocky,
so
yeah.
Must be a lot of, industry favorite kind of a person could have been.
Yeah, goodwill. A lot of goodwill he would generate.
Person with a goodwill.
Yeah, basically. Exactly. And he was, he used to approach all these people whom he is working with as friends, many people said there was never any tension on the sets. And, he just enjoyed his work and it was all, like fun and games and, there was no time period or there was absolutely no time bound abhi khatam karna hai, aise karna, nothing of the sort, It was a very relaxed kind of a atmosphere.
I think while she's saying, Anita ji is saying about Khosla Saab on the sets, I think it's a good time to see him on sets.
Yes, definitely. Yogesh has found something special.
Yogesh, can you play Solwa Saal, please?
Yeah.
There's a clip from Solwa Saal. Yogesh, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. It's so fun to watch.
And this goes on. I mean, there's a whole extended scene towards the end also where a necklace is stolen and the cops come in. He was remarkably confident in front of the camera, might I add.
This thing I observed in the interview also, the way he was enacting.
He looks very at ease. No, ekdam aaram se baithe hain baat ho rahi. Yeah. Okay, I think it's time for us to bring in Bindiya Chamkegi. Uske bina nahi hoga. Hamari bhi thodi kismat chamkegi. So let's first have a little chat about the song. But just before we
Bindiya, would you
before we just go there, I think Do Raaste bhi ek thodi alag si film hai as compared to all his others. So this is the other genre which he has done: noir, suspense thrillers, dacoity films, and then social films. And then within that, I think Do Raaste did really well. And we'll watch a song, but we'll first listen to how to watch that song and really uska kaise rasgrahan ho. To Karan ji se sunte hain.
Okay, again, I mean, Kaushal ji would be able to go much more into the intricacies of the music of that song, which is not obviously my area of thing. To me, what thing stands out is the picturization, which again, as we know, was thing Khosla Saab's thing strength. What amazes me is the way he's used the different elements on the roof of that house. The way he's used the shots, you know, with the pipe, he's framed them with darkness and just that thing, I think, circle. The way he's actually used, even the framing, you know, the pipe on top and the ladder on top, he makes Ki Mumtaz's face come over there. The pot lying on the roof, the mirror that is lying there to be able to see Mumtaz, you know, I think through that mirror on the roof. And of course, the emotions are playing through between Rajesh Khanna and her as she's trying to flirt with him and he's supposedly trying to study. And like every good Hindi film hero, they all studied psychology in college in those days. And he has this book, BA, I think, psychology guide thing over there. But I think it's beautifully picturized in terms of the way the music has been used, the way the playfulness between the two of them in that thing, romance. I mean, Mumtaz is just incredible in that thing song. And it's actually, apart from just, being the playful heroine, she's actually very sensual in that song, in the Do Raaste, which is actually brought out again, I think, beautifully. And then again, the trademark thing, you know, track-ins, I think, track-out, framing her, you know, behind the net, like I think Kaushal ji mentioned earlier, how we would frame characters with, you know, through windows or thing, you know, through obstructions. We see her through the net. Again, a beautifully choreographed shot where from a longer shot, she comes closer to the camera as the camera tracks, you know, I think to her. Or even the use of some, you know, very simple devices which make for very dynamic shots. Like when she goes and sits on the bed, and she, you know, I think plays with the pallu. There's a beautiful composition of her through the orange, I think, pallu in the thing, and we see Rajesh Khanna, I think, behind. He had a very, very strong visual sense how to use elements around. And I think Bindiya Chamkegi is a very, very good example of that. And again, the framing. I think simple device where she holds her hands, he comes in between and the camera, I think, tracks him for that to give the boundary of the frame over there. So I think it's actually one of the most, and again, you see his fluidity of his thing, camera work in this. It's all very, very beautifully done. To me, it's, I think, he's the picturized so many songs great. There is, I think, something special about, I think, Bindiya Chamkegi, really. Okay. In fact, you can ask if before we see it, if the Kaushal ji has anything more to add on the music. So we've got something further to go into when we see the song.
Just one thing, and then we may talk after seeing the song. So you notice the currently talked about the playfulness and the sensuality. In music, the way they have done it is using short phrases as dialogues, as question answers. So it's like paheli bujhana, and you know that format, that there are short conversations. It's like a rapid fire round between them. You know, it's there is no long sequence of musical phrases. It's always on the edge. So if you use short phrases and pauses, then there is a lot of scope for action and reaction. So in spite of the fact that it is a solo song, you can see that. We'll talk of
Yogesh
a little more after we see it.
So just before this song, if we have forgotten, I'm sure we haven't. उन्होंने jeans पहनी होती है, western clothes पहनकर मुमताज उनसे मिलने आती है, कहते हैं, oh, भारतीय औरत तो साड़ी में सुंदर लगती है. And then this.
Then she comes.
Then this happens.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's beautiful is actually their interplay.
Karan sir, just a second. May I request our guests here to switch on their cameras, please, so that the IT manager can take a couple of pictures. Yes, please, Karan sir, go ahead.
I was just saying that playfulness is great between them, and the song also works, you know, rather than being monotonous, because it has its ups and downs. From him actually trying not to look at her, him responding to her, trying to shake himself. So they have their own ups and downs in their, you know, in their graph, in their romance, which also kind of thing keeps it going. And the one great shot which I didn't really speak about was the use of the shadow when she talks about. So he's actually kept it framed for all this over there. And in the song, you also have a very standard, what I call the signature Raj Khosla shot. In many songs, you would have a mid-close shot of the character walking from right to left, and the camera will pan with that person. So when she talks about her long ka lashkara, that's a standard Raj Khosla shot. Even in Lagja Gale, there's a similar shot where Sadhna moves right to left. This we see the beginning of the Amitabh Bachchan Zeenat Aman romantic song in Dostana. They're walking right to left, then she's walking right to left, and the camera is panning with them in mid-close. So in the songs, one always looks for that signature thing, Raj Khosla shot, always, among other things, of course, in the song. But yeah, I think it's one of the all-time great picturized songs that I have seen.
Yes, Amarish. Yeah,
I would like to just add here that I've had it from the assistants that Rajji didn't really like to work with choreographers. Us zamane mein choreographers utne hote bhi nahi the. They used to be mostly dance masters. So while there was a certain dance master called Mr. Naidu, I think it was Manohar Naidu, I'm not sure the full name. But while he was credited and he was used to come and show a few steps, latke jhatke here and there, but not choreography in the sense that we understand today. So it was mostly Rajji and the heroine. So just with that information, if you look at this song now, I mean, it shows a different side to him. I mean, that choreography in that song, I mean, that the dances, the steps in that song, from a commercial perspective, I mean, that's what Madhuri and all those others later on imbibed, what Mumtaz ji did there in that song. So there were no choreographers to speak of. It was mostly Rajji's vision and the heroine.
I just like to add one trivia I had heard, that apparently when the film was finished and when Doraste ends, so Manoj Kumar was called to see the film, and he loved the song so much. He said, "Your movie is very good. It ends very beautifully, but put this song again in the end." So apparently the movie, in the reel itself, the song, the movie ends is like what we have today, the sort of the end title song.
Incredible.
It just comes as the end. But they had the song at the end. I think the public was very happy.
Yes.
You know, one
actually, sir, these people, I mean, must have given a lot of thought to it. Like, song has always been a very important and commercial property. Songs have made the films hit. There are so many films where the songs are a hit, though the film has not worked well. There were dance directors, there were dance masters, but the choreography term came much later. Maybe with Dil Se, people started knowing what a choreographer actually does.
See, with the great directors, I think they had their stamp that no matter who was their choreographer, you know, when we look at a Raj Khosla song, it's a Raj Khosla song. When we look at a Vijay Anand song, it could be a Hoto Pe Aisi Baat kind of a dance. It could be Oh Haseena Zulfon Wali. It's a Vijay Anand song. So I think the directors like Raj Kapoor, Guru Dutt, the songs also had their stamp. It's very clearly their songs.
Roshan?
Beautifully, I think, sort of picturized is Kuch Kehta Hai Saavan, you know, from Mera Gaon Mera Desh. I mean, I can just watch it once in 15 days just for the way it moves, you know, just the everything. Anyway, that was my...
And like how Sriram said, after the credits, Doraste, he did a similar thing. Unko shayad, I mean, what he used to experiment with these things, right? So Anita, I've never seen it happen in any Hindi film at any point of time. Anita has a whole song before the credits even roll. The opening credits, you see Anita, the name of the film. Normally, you used to see in the 70s and 80s film, if it's an action film, there was a bit of a prelude that happens, and then there's the title and everything. But in a romantic film like that, even before the name Anita comes on screen, there's a full song. And after that, the film starts happening. So that was a very unconventional thing to do those days.
Yeah, I think we should bring in Kaushal to talk about Bindiya. He was saying something.
Just two things that struck me now. You know, like I said, Raj ji never imposed his personality, but let the best of that music composer come out. Now, Lakshmikant Pyarelal have been known for their irreverence for grammar of the words. They had certain, sometimes, you know, like we, when we speak, you don't put a full stop where the full stop is. So if I am saying, get the milk, you know, don't be impudent. So I'll say, get the milk. Don't be impudent is not what I'll say. I'll say, get the milk, don't be impudent. I won't put that full stop there while speaking. So you can see the play of the words here in Bindiya Chamkegi, especially in the Antara. Bole Kangna. So every, as I said, short phrases, after the pause is very pregnant after every musical phrase. So, and then just see this. Bole Kangna, kisi ka o sajna, jawani pe zor nahi, bole Kangna. No full stop here. Bole Kangna, kisi ka o sajna, jawani pe zor nahi. लाख मना कर ले दुनिया कहते हैं मेरे घुंघरू पायल बाजेगी. You see, there is no full stop here, and this is quintessential Lakshmikant Pyarelal. You will see it in many songs. Okay, so they show no reverence to the grammar of the line that has been. So they will always give it a musical grammar, not they'll disregard the grammar of language totally. And here you see another thing that I noticed apart from in picturization was the shot of the Pallu in the last Antara. You know, it divides the screen diagonally, and you see Rajesh Khanna here and again the obstructed face of Mumtaz. That कुछ बात है लेकिन मैं पूरी कहूंगा नहीं. दैट ऑलवेज दैट अनसेड दैट बिटवीन द लाइंस वॉज ऑलवेज टोल्ड एंड कन्वेड इवन विजुअली. इट जस्ट डिडंट हैपन इन द वर्ड्स. दैट्स
दैट्स अ वेरी नाइस वे टू पुट.
Yeah. And she actually pulls it out when she rebels and says ki main na baithungi. Again, I think that the key words in that when she sings is ki maine mohabbat ki hai, gulami nahi.
Gulami nahi.
That was, I thought, was very important. Again,
very important, because like I said, just before that he has said ki tum ye libas mat pehno, ye acha nahi lagta. Theek hai, main pehen ke aa gayi hu jo aapko acha lag raha hai. But it's not all done. Like, I'm not going to listen to everything that you're saying. I have myself.
That she has her own identity.
I have my own person. Yeah. I'm my own person. So just a little bit about, I think in all his women, the women characters that he has, there's this streak of, I'm somebody. Like, you can't just make me this, okay, this is the other female lead who's going to sing and dance. And ठीक है वो भी मैं करूंगी, बट आई ऑल्सो हैव समथिंग टू ऑफर. ये उनकी सारी वुमेन कैरेक्टर्स के अंदर देखने को मिलता है कि कुछ ना कुछ, इवन इफ इट्स द नेगेटिव कैरेक्टर्स, जैसे काला पानी में आप देखते हैं नलिनी जयवन का जो कैरेक्टर है, सीआईडी में जो वहीदा जी का कैरेक्टर है, तो उनके अंदर भी इट्स दीज वुमेन आर वेरी ब्यूटिफुली पोर्ट्रेड इन हिस्टोरी. पिक्चराइजेशन एक बात है, लेकिन आपने कहानी में ही उनको कुछ दिया है. यू हैव गिवन सम एसेंस टू ईच वन ऑफ देम. कुछ कहानी है उनकी पीछे, ऐसे नहीं कि बस एक ठीक है मुझे एक आई नीड दिस वुमन हियर तो मैंने उनको डाल दिया. तो ये शुरुआती खासकर उनकी फिल्मों में बहुत ही खूबसूरत किरदार औरतों के हैं, बहुत सुंदर तरह से पिक्चराइज भी किए. आई शुड जस्ट थैंक हिम कि हमें देखने को मिली है ऑल दीज ब्यूटिफुल एक्ट्रेसेस पोर्ट्रेइंग दीज वंडरफुल कैरेक्टर्स. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट.
क्या हम कौशल से अब रिक्वेस्ट करें कि
समय थोड़ा किल्लत,
क्योंकि यहाँ आर डी बर्मन साहब की बर्थ एनिवर्सरी भी है और राजकोट साहब को हम ट्रिब्यूट कर रहे हैं
जी,
दोनों का एक साथ किया हुआ वन ऑफ हिज लेटर फिल्म्स सनी, जो कि आर डी बर्मन लता मंगेशकर कॉम्बिनेशन है,
अगेन यूनिक थिंग, बिल्कुल।
कौशल कैन वी हियर? अच्छा एक मैं सजेस्ट करना चाह रहा था कौशल, हारमोनियम सुनाई नहीं पड़ रहा है?
अरे हारमोनियम है ही नहीं मेरे पास एक्चुअली, आई एम यूजिंग द कीबोर्ड एंड इट्स अनकंफर्टेबल फॉर मी, बट लेट मी सी।
नहीं नहीं कोई नहीं कोई नहीं,
नहीं ठीक है सर, आप आपको जो
कंफर्टेबल, यू आर गिविंग सम कीज बट वी वर नॉट एबल टू,
या ठीक है, लिटिल क्लियर,
थोड़ा सा बेटर हुआ है पहले से लेकिन अभी भी लो है, जस्ट एफआईआर,
या इट्स बिकॉज़ लेट मी सी आई कैन come close to that speaker. So in
जाने हार्मोनियम बजती है ना कौशल जी, हार्मोनियम बजती है तो राजकोसला साहब का ट्रिब्यूट वहां कंप्लीट
हो गया,
अभी सुनाई पड़ रहा है,
या बहुत शुक्रिया बड़ी मेहरबानी मेरी जिंदगी में हुजूर आप आए, या दैट्स आई नो दैट यू नो लाइक आई सेड इन डिफरेंट सॉन्ग्स ही हैज क्रिएटेड टाइम, यू नो व्हेन एवरीथिंग इज द पेस ऑफ द स्टोरी इज गोइंग इट्स एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट टू क्रिएट दैट यू नो दैट नथिंग इज हैपनिंग काइंड ऑफ थिंग एंड येट नॉट बोर पीपल, it's extremely difficult, it's very rare because it, you know, like that in many stories once you start with the storytelling then that inertia is so much and that song should remain part of that story, that so for example two songs in Bombay Ka Babu, Saathi Na Koi Manzil, okay, look at the pace he actually creates that time and that fursat, दिल ढूंढता है फिर वही फुर्सत, वो मिल गई थी राज जी को एक्चुअली, सो गालिब केप्ट लुकिंग फॉर इट बट ही गॉट इट, यू नो देन इवन चल रही सजनी क्लाइमैक्स में सॉन्ग है लेकिन इतना फुर्सत में गाया हुआ है एंड दे गिव दैट टाइम, ओके जस्ट बिकॉज आई एम ऑन बम्बई का बाबू, जस्ट वन ऑब्जर्वेशन दैट आई डिड रिगार्डिंग द पिक्चराइजेशन, इन दीवाना मस्ताना you'll find a shot of Devanand Saab like this, it's a very similar shot to Pehla Nasha in Jojita Bhai Sikandar, the same background of the hills, same Aamir Khan in a sweater and you know longi, both songs written by Majroo Sultanpuri, coincidence. So like Mark Twain said that only Adam, when he said a good thing, knew that nobody had said it before him. So people are telling the same story all over again and in the similar idioms. The same thing is about Jaane Kya Baat Hai. You know, it's my go-to song if the world is in a chaos and I have to be at peace with myself. So you see that again, that long phrase is there, unlike that Bindiya Chamkegi, where that fursat has been created. So this jaane kya baat hai, jaane kya baat hai, neend nahi aati, बड़ी लंबी रात है, जाने क्या बात है, जाने क्या बात है, सारी 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 रात मुझे किसने जगाया, जैसे कोई सपना जैसे कोई साया कोई नहीं लगता है, कोई मेरे साथ है जाने क्या बात है, जाने क्या बात है। This extreme peace, and then you sing that song. It actually it was a thing of a past by the time we came to the 80s. They needed that, you know, that because of television already in the, there was a compulsion of the increased pace in a song, and yet I think, and with that, with R.D. Burman, it was such a fantastic thing that he did. The actually the whole story of Sunny goes in a pace which is not really in sync with those times. I like that film for different reasons, and that Fursat that you don't get anywhere, he created it for us at that time. So there is some different value in things that, you know, you feel that why is that song good? It's a regular nazm, but it creates that time and does not let you shift attention from it for a single moment. That is the virtue of that song. Just that's all I have to say, but just one passing observation again. Mr. Kapoor said about O. Henry, you know, that he had a lot of O. Henry books with him. Okay, that character of the film inspector, the character of the inspector in Bombay Ka Babu is straight out of an O. Henry book. O. Henry story.
After
20 years, yeah. Or there is another story of the safe, you know, where the policeman goes to catch him, but he sees the crook open the safe and rescue a child, and then he refuses to arrest him. That is O. Henry, and that's, you know, the adaptations when they are infused with original thought add to the quality of that storytelling is always what I feel. Yeah. It's been wonderful here, you know, talking to all of you and listening and adding to my own knowledge. Shriram ji, I am a big fan, and it was such a interesting thing to listen to Karan ji and Amborish as well. I am looking forward to the book. And
let us hear some more thoughts.
Thank you so much.
Wait for the book.
Kaushal ji, I just had a small bit to add about Jaane Kya Baat Hai. You would be pleased to know, aap bol rahe the na ki this, the song seems like it harks back to a previous era.
Yeah.
This song is actually, you know, the tune was made earlier in a Bengali song. So everybody who knows Pancham knows that he used to come out with these songs earlier. During Durga Puja in
Calcutta.
So the interesting thing is this song was sung by Asha Bhosle, composed by Pancham in the Bengali album called Chokhe Name Brishti. And then eventually for Sunny, he made Lataji sing it. I don't think there is a parallel like that before.
Interesting. It's very rare.
But the good part about this song is it actually lets the raat to go long, as it is said.
Yes.
Yes.
बड़ी लंबी रात है तो वो लंबी लगती, लंबी रात वो गाने में रिप्रेजेंट होती
है। सनी एक्चुअली ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम वेयरएवर ही इज टू दूरदर्शन ऑफिसर्स टू मीट अमृता सिंह, सो इट्स प्रीटी लॉन्ग।
Yeah, it's actually long. Yeah, thank you so much, Kaushal ji. Thank you so much, everyone. But I think we just have some small concluding things to say. Milind ji had some very wonderful observations. They say ki the fact that he's a very bankable man, go-to man by in his own times with a lot of goodwill. ऐसी बहुत सारी अच्छी-अच्छी बातें हमें पता चली उनके बारे में. Other than just Raj Khosla ji, the filmmaker, Raj Khosla ji, the father, the man who had a wonderful loyal team. Jo Ambarish ke research se hame bhi kuch pata chala ki people who celebrate his birthdays even today. ये बहुत ही मिलिंद और मेरे लिए बहुत ही खूबसूरत जर्नी रहा उनकी फिल्में देखना बात करना सभी लोगों से सो आई थिंक ऑल वी कैन से शो अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रैटिट्यूड टू द मैन एंड हिज वर्क राइट मिलिंद जी
ये फिल्म एक्चुअली सारी फिल्में देखी मगर एक चीज जो पता चली बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है जो क्योंकि हम सॉन्ग्स और सॉन्ग पिक्चराइजेशन को लेके बात करते हैं मैं तो रिसर्च ही कर रहा हूँ गोल्डी साहब पे तो मेरे ख्याल से राज खोसला साहब को ये पता चल गया था कि गाना इंडियन हाउसहोल्ड का पार्ट बन चुका है एंड ही बॉट इट ही गॉट दैट एस्पेक्ट इन एक बंगला बने न्यारा विद टेकिंग द राइट आई मीन हैविंग द राइट्स ऑफ दैट सॉन्ग ऑफ के एल सहगल एंड दैट सॉन्ग इज प्लेड ट्वाइस वन व्हेन देयर इज अ गुड टाइम व्हेन ही इज सेइंग द बलराज सहनी इज एक्चुअली इन गुड स्पेसेस गुड टाइम गुड हेल्दी लाइफ दैट ही इज लिविंग और बाद में वही गाना जब बजता है जब वो सारा स्कैटर्ड हो चुका है तो एक घर का पार्ट हो गया है हिंदी फिल्म का गाना ये जो चीज तब तक हो चुकी थी वो खोसला साहब ने फिल्म के थ्रू ही एक बार अंडरलाइन करके लोगों के सामने रखी तो एक तरह का ट्रिब्यूट भी था सहगल साहब के लिए और दूसरा ये पार्ट जो है कि इंडियन हाउस होल्ड का पार्ट एक बन चुका है हिंदी फिल्म का गाना तो ये चीज काफी ऐसी चीजें पता चली जो आप सब लोगों ने जो ज्ञानवर्धन अगर मैं कहूँ तो वो सही वर्ड होगा क्योंकि इसी से सब लोगों को पता चलती है चीजें आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक ऑल द मेंबर्स सर इज हियर सर वुड यू लाइक टू
या आई जस्ट वांट टू मेंशन वन थिंग आई मीन यू हैड सीन दैट ही मेड अ लॉट ऑफ मूवीज विद हॉर्सेस सो ही हैड अ रियल फॉन्डनेस फॉर हॉर्सेस And he was a good rider himself, which translated into all his horse movies.
Knowledge also of horses.
Yeah, he was very fond of horses.
Had a horse.
Yeah, they also had, they owned a horse, which he used to ride and his daughters used to ride.
How the way, that's a, I mean, very good observation. Even Naqab has horses. Yeah, right. Yes, मैं तुलसी तेरे आंगन की में वो गिरते हैं घोड़े से गोल्डी साहब है यस थैंक यू कपूर साहब ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट आपने जाते जाते आप ले आए सर कैंथोला सर वुड यू लाइक टू से समथिंग
आर वी वाइंडिंग अप नाउ
यस कपूर साहब आप कुछ कहना चाह रहे हैं नहीं ओके यस सर
ओके ओके नहीं बस आई वांटेड टू thank all the panelists you know I feel that FTI has done a wonderful job in bringing Raj Khosla to the audience today as some of the panelists have said that perhaps he never got his due when he was there and in spite of having made such super duper films songs that are even remembered today and I'm with this eminent panel that we had Shriram Raghavan ji and Ambarish and Kaushal Inamdar, of course, he took this discussion to a very musical level and you know, brought out the finer nuances of the songs that were essential part of his song, of his films. So this has been a wonderful discussion and I'm sure that when this recording is made available on our website, thousands more would have, you know, they will get access to it and they will remember Raj Khosla and the brilliant work that he did. So thank you also to Vaidehi and Milind for putting this panel together and presenting such a wonderful discussion. Thank you.
Yes. I'd like to thank Mr. Shatrughan Sinha also. For short notice, he also came. Anita ji, Kapoor saab, Uma ji.
Thank you.
Bahut bahut shukriya and we are looking forward to the book, Ambarish. So all the best to you and it would be a wonderful book to have a book on Raj Khosla itself. Great idea. I mean, we need that.
Thank you.
So, Shriram sir, Karan sir, Kaushal, Ambarish.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.